Hey, it's me, Mainly Butch. I'm compelled to make this woody video this morning. Because I haven't been making videos lately until I get my teeth fixed. I didn't want to do it, but you know what? This is important. So what if I got a missing tooth? So, anyway, I'm pissed. And I hope every other citizen and veteran in this country is absolutely fucking outraged right now. Because Trump, the guy can't keep his feet out of his mouth, okay? You know, they should lock the man in the bunker and take his phone away until this is over, because he's not doing himself any good. It's now come to light through several different really reliable sources, including the Associated Press, for one, you know, and they're not a fake news organization. They have no reason to be. They are a worldwide service. And, you know, I'm sure Reuters is on this too. So anyway, that Trump has been using very, very hateful, denigrating, cowardly words about the United States military, all branches. Specifically Marines, though, just so y'all know. I know Marines are the real hardcore. I was in the Army for 6 years, so, you know, I know. My dad was a Marine. I have a lot of friends that are Marines. I was born on a Marine base, okay? The fact that the Commander-in-Chief of the United States Military Forces, which he is supposed to be, okay, has such hate for veterans, does not want them in his parades or at any of his events, because in his own words, okay, it's not a good look. I don't like that. He doesn't like seeing amputees or people in wheelchairs or veterans wearing Purple Hearts, because he calls them losers. You know, he used another word to losers and suckers. Yeah. Yeah. Just so you know, Marines, the below woods, you know, B-E-L-L-E-A-U, below, I don't know how they say it, Belleau Woods, battle that you all fought years ago. It's a very famous Marine battle where 1,800 Marines were lost. He said that those men were losers and suckers because they were killed. And sorry, my dog has to bark. And he doesn't understand why they would have even gone into battle. What was it in it for them? What was it worth? Were they being paid? If you aren't being paid, if there's no money involved, it doesn't affect him, you know? I mean, the fact that people gave their lives, their freedom, their family lost them, fighting for democracy somewhere in the world or here in the United States is... And he has no respect for them, and no, he's not thankful for democracy, he's not thankful for our military. Yeah, losers and suckers, guys, that's what he thinks we are, okay? Active duty, veterans, everybody. And this really happened. This is the truth. He stood at John Kelly's son's grave, and John Kelly's son was killed in battle. With John Kelly standing next to him, and he looked at John Kelly, and he says, "I don't get it. What's in it for them?" Can you imagine saying that to a man as he's standing at his dead son's grave? Yeah, no, I don't either. The repeated denigration and scorn that he has showed and has said about the United States military is unbelievable. It's disgusting, you know, he's disgusting. He's called amputees and disabled veterans disgusting. He doesn't want them at his parades because it doesn't look good, and he doesn't like that. He doesn't want them seen in public or near him. You know, there was a story about Trump that we heard before he got elected where a man was at his Mar-a-Lago resort and fell, had a stroke or something, and fell on the dance floor and hit his head when he fell, and there was blood, and Trump was so repulsed by the blood, okay, that he's like, get that mess off my floor. He had no concern about the man at all. He was worried and disgusted by the blood. You know? You don't know how bad I hate this man. You don't know how bad I hate Trump. You know? I actually think that Canadians should come down here and pull another 1812, and we should help them. But anyway, I don't understand. You know, he made statements like, what's in it for them? They don't make any money. You know, he claims that POWs were poorly performing, so they deserve what they got. He said that they deserve what they got. He's going to deserve what he gets, too. You know, whether it's, you know, somebody out there doing us a favor, or whether it's him being voted out and dragged out of the White House and thrown into jail. I don't care what it is. You know, the man is going to deserve whatever nastiness happens to him. All of it. I want to see him in an orange jumpsuit eating prison loaf. That's what I want to see. And anybody who's ever been to jail or knows anything about jail or is a corrections officer, y'all know what prison loaf is. It's the stuff that they mix up and feed the dogs. And they make you eat it if you won't eat. You know, even Fox News has confirmed all of this stuff, guys. Even Fox News is disgusted. And they're disgusted. But they're disgusted with their little boy. They don't even want him on their show anymore. You know, this originally came out in an article in Atlantic Magazine by Jeff Goldberg. Trump's administration tried to deny it at first, and then all these people came out of the woodwork that were there when he said things, and they confirmed all of it. All of it. The Washington Post confirmed it. The LA, New York Times confirmed it. The Atlantic confirmed it. The Associated Press confirmed it. It was confirmed by several upper-level people in his administration that were there when he said it, standing next to him. It was confirmed by John Kelly. This is an outrage. An outrage. You know, he deserves nothing. You know, he doesn't deserve any respect. He deserves nothing. The man is a dog, you know, and he deserves to be treated like one. I'm done with this guy. I can't wait till November 3rd, you know, and y'all better be guarding that White House, because he's going to destroy it. He's probably going to, like, destroy all the doses of the coronavirus vaccine that he's got built up. He's going to start trying more nasty war stuff with our enemies. He's going to do a lot of crap between November 3rd and January 20th, 2021. I hope somebody's got all of that in mind, because this is not a guy that's going to go out easy. And he's going to do some really nasty shit. And what he doesn't think of, that fucking Jared Kushner guy will. Or what's the racist guy, Stephen Miller, the most racist man in America. He'll admit it. And he is standing right there next to Trump, his number one advisor on immigration. The most racist man in America. He's like, he's a member of the KKK. David Duke has made him an honorary, like, I don't know what they call him, High Dutch Duke or something like that. Yeah. We got some real rats in the White House. We need to clean them the fuck out. And I don't blame anybody that stops their son or daughter or friend or husband or wife or anybody from going into the United States military right now. Don't do it. If you're thinking about doing it, don't do it till after January. Okay? See if this guy's still going to be your commander-in-chief. Because if he is, don't enlist. No. Not until we have a whole new way of doing things. Anyway, as a veteran, as a United States citizen, and as somebody who deeply cares, okay? I, mainly Butch, my name is Angie. I declare my absolute hatred for this man. I am completely against everything he has said. He has just addressed all of this with a rank callousness and disregard for family members. He can't remember the names of family members that have died when he calls their wives to tell him or their husbands to tell him. You know, he has no decency or kindness, no empathy, nothing. You know, so... Yeah, it's sick. So I encourage everybody to write to the White House, to call the White House, to call every senator you got. Let's make a stink. Peace.